What are you doing? You're not gonna get a deer laying in bed.
While some of us will never truly understand the emotional roller coaster of chasing the most sought after animal on the planet, the whitetail. The beast inside keeps us all motivated to do so.
I'm pretty sure I just bumped something. I can hear the squirrels going off. About 100 yards, 75 yards over that way, maybe. Just taking a nice slow pace in here. I'm gonna go get my butt in a tree.
It's the end of October, with a few missed opportunities and a few more lessons learned. All we can do is push forward as we move into the next phase of archery season.
Since the bucks are starting to follow the does here in late October, I'm gonna get up in that location where, right there's another scrape. I'm gonna go up and do an evening sit where I've had all those bucks come in on my trail camera. See if they're pushing some does around yet. Wow, this is a good heavy trail right here. My original path in here. Thought I'd come this way to find a more direct route. Using this pretty hard.
I try not to lose sight of what's in front of me. The beauty and the pureness of being outdoors. Everything that comes with the season, and why we're out here. With 200 square miles of public land, many transitions, it's freedom. It doesn't get much better than this.
All the leaves are falling pretty good. It hasn't rained a couple of days, so everything is starting to get crunchy. Usually when I come into this spot, I follow the creek this way. There's an old log road that comes down through. I probably should have come in that way, but anyway, at least we saw some good sign coming in the way I did. Fresh grapes, fresh tracks.
So follow along on this journey as I track down the bucks that I've been seeing all preseason while scouting. I know there's 7 different bucks in this location within 2 square miles. Things are about to get pretty exciting for me, and I don't even know it yet. Trail. Found some new sign along the way, a couple of fresh scrapes. It's October 24th, and it's 1 p.m. I finally made it up my tree. No problems. I was close to this spot at the beginning of the week. I was able to get out for an evening hunt, and I was on the ground. And I was looking at my phone, checking out some pictures from my trail camera cards. And I heard some squirrels going off behind me, about 75 yards. Didn't pay much attention. I mean, I was alert, but I still kept my head in my phone. And they got louder and louder. So I stood up and turned around real slow to look up that direction. And out of the corner of my left eye, there he stood. He's about 30 yards away, staring right at me. So the buck's on my left. My bow is hanging on my right side because I'm now facing the opposite direction. And I couldn't move. I put my head against a tree and I thought, well, if I turn around real slow, I'll know where he's going. But if I don't, I'll have no idea. So I turned around and he was right in front of me about 15 yards. He really didn't know what I was, so he just kind of trotted off. But wow, really caught me off guard. So this time I'm in here, I got up a tree pretty high. Let's see what happens. Shot there. That buck was coming up behind me to my right, and he was just cruising right by.
was close. Too much crap in the way. I couldn't get him on film behind me or to my right because my camera arm didn't reach. I can hear him blowing. I'll sit tight a couple more minutes. That buck came in about 40 yards to my right and he just cruised right by. That was actually the same buck I saw on Monday. He went right by that tree that I was sitting in Monday night. I was hoping maybe he was just circling around in front of me. But I heard a bunch of squirrels up there about 100 yards. So he's probably not coming back.
Well, we win some and we lose some. I'll always and forever take the memories with me.